One of the many things I love about Pokémon and Pokémon Go is the amazing creatures inspired by plants. My personal favorite is Radish, but there are a lot of really cool ones. Today, I'm going to talk about the real-world plants that inspired some of the first-generation Pokémon. This first Pokémon is one of my favorites, Victreebel. In Pokémon Go, it starts out as Bellsprout, which evolves into Weepinbell, and finally into Victreebel. All of these Pokémon are based on pitcher plants. For Victreebel specifically, I'm reminded most of pitcher plants in the genus Nepenthes. These colorful and impressive plants grow in tropical areas such as South America, China, and the Philippines. They generally grow as vines, and they are carnivorous plants, meaning that they get some of their nutrients by digesting prey, such as insects. They do this with their modified leaves, known as pitchers. That little lid, which is also present on Victreebels, protects the pitcher until it is formed completely and is ready to catch prey. As you can see, the pitchers are cup-shaped, and they have a pool of digestive enzymes at their base. The plant produces sugary nectar to draw in insects, and the inside of the pitcher is unstable and slippery. So once an insect goes inside, it slides down into that pool of liquid and drowns. This allows the pitcher to break it down and sap out nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus. Most Nepenthes catch insects, but a few, like Nepenthes raja, are large enough to catch things like rats and lizards. These are unusual, however, and most of their prey consists of insects. Some Nepenthes species also have symbiotic relationships with insects in addition to being a predator. Nepenthes bicaltrata, a Borneo native known as the fanged pitcher plant for the two fang-like wings below its lid, has a symbiotic relationship with carpenter ants. The tendrils of this plant are perfect for ant nests, and the ants and plant help each other out. The ants get a home and can feed on the other insects attracted to the pitcher plant. The plant, in turn, feeds on the poop of the resident ants, and the ants even keep the plant clean. The liquid in these pitchers is even more alkaline than other species, less acidic, making them a more welcoming home to those ants. So who knows, maybe Victreebel has some ant friends. Either way, it's a Pokemon that represents a very cool genus of carnivorous plants. And next, I'm going to talk about a Pokemon I often see available for raid battles. Executor? How do you... There are a few plants that could be compared to, but it reminds me most of an economically important plant, the coconut tree. Scientific name, Cocos nucifera, the coconut tree is in the palm family, Ericaceae. It is most known for its fruit, which, despite their name, are not nuts, but drupes. And that would mean that those grinning heads on Executor are actually coconuts. Coconuts are used for a variety of things, and not just for food. Their coconut oil is great for cooking and for use in cosmetics, and the water and milk are both used in food. Even the meat itself can be eaten. The tough husks of the coconuts can be used as charcoal, and the trunk of the tree itself can be used to build houses and huts. The fronds can be woven or used to make things like brooms. Because of their utility, coconuts are a big crop. In 2014, nearly 30 million acres of coconut trees were cultivated, according to data from the Food and Agriculture Organization of the UN. Countries with the highest production include Sri Lanka, the Philippines, Mexico, India, and Brazil. Coconut trees require a lot of water, so need a lot of irrigation and flourish in humid environments. So I guess make sure you keep your executors well hydrated. As I mentioned earlier, this last Pokemon is my favorite, and that is Radish. It's just so smiley and happy. Anyway, as its name indicates, Radish looks a bit like a radish. The scientific name for radishes is Raphanus raphastranum subspecies sativus. There are many varieties of radish, and they come in all sorts of shapes, sizes, and colors. The part of the radish that we eat is actually the taproot, and this is what the flower of the plant looks like. It's believed that it originated in the eastern Mediterranean region, and it is a cultivated version of a wild species in the genus. It's now grown around the world. Radishes are primarily a food crop and are eaten raw, cooked, or pickled. And in Oaxaca, Mexico, they are carved to make intricate sculptures. Every December 23rd, on the Night of the Radishes, artists compete for a prize for the best creation made out of radishes. The event was first officially recognized in 1897. The radishes are grown specifically for the event, so they're usually really huge and can't be eaten. This tradition is said to have originated as a way to entice shoppers at produce stands, but today's sculptures are massive and elaborate. This sounds like an amazing tradition that I can say I was super delighted by. All right, that's it for today's Pokemon-inspired video. If there are any other plant-based Pokemon you'd like me to talk about, please let me know in the comments. There are definitely a lot more of them. As a reminder, I have a t-shirt campaign going on right now. If you go to the link in the description or on the screen, you can pick up one of these snazzy limited edition shirts and support Brilliant Botany in the process. It's only available through 8 p.m. Eastern on August 16th, so get one while you can. You can also support me by becoming my supporter on Patreon. Even $1 a month makes a huge difference and helps me keep up with software fees, website hosting fees, all that sort of thing. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next week.